Start the new portion, that is Combus survey. So just as an introduction, this is an introductory part. Okay, so next day onwards we will be discussing more definitions and all, and after that only we can start the problem portions. That is why, so when we are talking about Combus survey directly, what is coming to our mind? So this is direction. Okay, so Combus means whenever we are thinking, we will get the term direction. So north, south, east, west, everybody will be knowing. If I am marking this angle theta and if I am marking this line, this is meant to be northeast portion because this is midway between north and east. So this theta, this is called the angle, or in the civil engineering term we can call it as the direction. Okay, so here we are going to discuss more important terms. As some drawings are there, that's why I didn't make PDF. So I didn't made any presentation as important terms are there. So important terms, first we will study the meridian. What is actually meridian? Okay, so I want to measure this angle. Okay, I want to measure an angle in the line. So I want what? I want a fixed reference point, fixed reference line I want. Okay, then only I can measure angle. Then from where I will measure angle? I want a fixed reference line I want. With this fixed reference line, I am going to measure this angle. Okay. So, what is actually called the meridian? Meridian means it is a fixed reference line in which direction or angle is measured. Okay, so this is actually meridian, and we are going to study different types of meridian also. So understood what is meridian? Different types of meridians are there. First is true meridian. What is actually true meridian? So this is our earth. Okay, so our north south, when we mark as it is straight for the practical purpose, for the theoretical purpose, it will not be every time like this. There is a slight deviation from this straight north. Okay, so this will be the north and this will be the south. It will not be pure as straight perpendicular. Okay, so it will have a slight inclination and that will be perpendicular in that way. So this is the north and south actually, and we can say, or we can call it as the geographical north or true north, and this we can call it as the geographical south or true south. So what we can say as true meridian means it is a line joining true north or true south, or we can say that it is a line joining by the geographical north and geographical south, and this is established by, this is most important question, established by what? Astronomical observation. Astronomical observations. Okay, don't forget it. So true meridian means it's a line joining true north or true south, or geographical north and geographical south, and it is established by the astronomical observations. Next, second one is magnetic meridian. We can call it as MM. So we know that this is our earth. So as the true north is here, but again there can be a deviation. There can be a deviation again. So this is magnetic north and this is magnetic south. So we can say, what is magnetic meridian? It is a line joining magnetic north and magnetic south. It is the direction shown by freely floating magnetic needle free from all the forces. It is established by what? Established by the magnetic compass. So true meridian established by astronomical observation, and magnetic meridian is established by the free floating magnet. So magnetic compass it is. Next type of meridian is the grid meridian. Grid meridian is nothing but for the survey of a state if we are considering. So true meridian of a central place, we are referring medium of a whole state. So likewise we called it as grid meridian. So all the area, if this is the earth, if we want to consider a particular state, we will consider this grid meridian. That is for survey of a state, true meridian of the central place will be the reference meridian for whole state. We are just considering one particular area for any particular state. That is called the grid meridian. Next is called the arbitrary meridian. Arbitrary meridian is the meridian taken in the direction towards a mark or a permanent, towards a mark or sign, that is which is permanent, that is to determine the relative directions. It is small traverse or small area we can refer. So it is the meridian taken in any direction towards a mark or a sign which is permanent to determine the relative directions. It can be a small traverse or a small area. So for that, only for small traverse or a small area only, we are using this arbitrary meridian. Now some important points which are there. So we have said that there are true meridian as well as magnetic meridian in the earth. So slight variation, there is a true meridian, and that true meridian means here it will be what, true north, and here it will be true south. So there is a magnetic meridian as the terms of freely magnetic compass, that is magnetic meridian is this. So this is magnetic north and this is magnetic south. So there will be an angle between the true meridian and the magnetic meridian. Okay, so this angle we can say it as the angle of declination. Okay, what we can say? Angle of declination or magnetic declination. What we can say? So it is the difference, it is the angle difference between, angle difference between true meridian and the magnetic meridian. Okay, so this magnetic declination, when it moves towards the east direction, we can consider it as positive. For the calculation purpose, it will be useful. That's why I said. And if it is west, we can consider it as negative. Okay, and we can say that this magnetic declination, it will not be a constant. It is not a constant value. It varies from time to time. This is also very important. It varies from time to time. These all points are really important. Okay. Next most important point is that this mariners, okay, this travelers, this mariners called the declination as variation. That is also very important point. Variations, declination as variations. And what do you mean by isogonic lines? Isogonic lines means when a line drawn with same declination point, okay, if I am drawing a line with in the earth, if I am drawing several lines with same declination, okay, so line drawn through points of same declination, we can call it as isogonic lines. Next is agonic lines. Agonic lines means line made up of points having zero declination. Okay, zero declination means no change in the angle between true meridian and magnetic meridian. So these type of lines we can call it as agonic lines. Next important point is the direction of a true meridian. Is it variable or invariable? This will be a question. It will be invariable. Okay, the direction of true meridian will not be variable. It will always be invariable. Okay, it will not change. It will be as a constant only. Next thing is that true meridian through various stations are not parallel. We can say that it cannot be parallel. Some deviations will be there, but it will converge to the poles. It will converge to the poles means what? This upper portion and below portion. So it will converge to the poles actually. But for calculation purpose or for small areas, we are considering it as to be parallel. For calculation for small areas, we are considering it as parallel. Next thing is bearing. So what do you mean by bearing? Okay, so meridian we have studied now. So this is a survey line. Okay, I want to take all the things related with the survey line. So this is the meridian. Okay, so this angle between this meridian and the survey line, this is called as the bearing actually. So bearing means what? Angle between meridian and the survey line. This is also divided into four similar type of that meridian. We can call the first as true bearing. So what is true bearing? True bearing is otherwise called as azimuth. This is very, very important. Every time it can be asked, and every time you have to think that this is a constant value. These two are very, very important. True bearing, it is otherwise called as azimuth, and it is constant, and it is does not change with the time. That is why it is constant. Does not change with time. Okay, so we said that this is true bearing and this is the survey line. So this is the angle. So this is called as the true bearing of the line. Next is magnetic bearing. It is not a constant value because we know it will affected by the magnet. So changes with time. Okay, and that's why it is used for small areas. So this is magnetic bearing and this is the survey line. So this is the magnetic bearing. Next is the grid meridian. Same like grid bearing. Okay, similar to that of grid meridian, here comes the grid bearing. Horizontal angle with the, it is the horizontal angle. Horizontal angle of survey line with the grid meridian. Same way. Now we have said now, if this is the grid meridian and the angle with the survey line, this will be the grid bearing. Same way only arbitrary also. Arbitrary bearing. So that is also same. If this is the arbitrary meridian and the angle between arbitrary meridian and the survey line will become the arbitrary bearing. Horizontal angle. Every time we are considering horizontal angle. Okay. Next is the systems of bearings. So we have one WCB, whole circle bearing. Okay. Whole circle bearing, and second is the quadrantal bearing. Okay, so this onwards we will be studying in the next portion video. So please watch the session. It is very, very important. Really, it is important. So I will be making a PPT format and I will be taking the class, so it will be easy for you to understand. As this is the basic portion, I have taken directly in the Zoom class. So please do watch all the videos till the end, and please put the genuine comments in the comment box. And if you like my session, please subscribe and like the session. And if you want the upcoming notifications, please click the bell icon nearby. And tomorrow we will be starting from the systems of bearings. These all are very much important portions, and after that we can directly go to the problem portions because it is relevant in the examination point of view problems. So let us watch till tomorrow.